Guys, at the first stop of the week, first thrift shop. Let's see if they got anything. Peace. What's up, guys? I did get a little tiny clip in there. Someone's driving like a maniac. Did get a tiny little clip in there. I was super psyched when I saw that on Umisha Dawn of Dreams. I have it, but it's only disc one and manual only. And their copy in there was only disc one and manual only. That sucked. I did pick up three of those items though, and we will see them in the pickups. Peace. And stop of the day, we're at a pawn shop and see if we find anything. Peace. Up, guys, we're just leaving the second pawn shop. This one is slowly becoming the honey hole pawn shop because I find something every time I'm here. Spent a little bit of money, spent $17 on only two games, but they're worth it. And yeah, pretty good titles. So we're gonna hit up the old honey hole, and that will probably be it today. But see you guys in a bit. Peace. Alright guys, we're back in my house, the honey hole, I guess, the ex-honey hole now. I didn't have anything at all, not even anything new, which was very strange. Because usually if I don't go for a while there, they at least have new stuff. Nothing. So, that was it for the day, that was the last stop. Hit up some places tomorrow maybe, and we'll see you then. Peace. Didn't find anything at Goodwill, but we're at the local Hastings, it's closing down. 16% off. Pick up that guy right there. What's up, guys? It's Small Town Retro Gamer back at the Goodwill. Let's see if they got anything. Peace. Weird dolls. There's the game. Bunch of sports, state of emergency, we play. Pretty extreme back there still. What is up, guys? We just left the Goodwill. I didn't end up picking anything up. Those creepy dolls. Wasn't going to grab them. My Goodwill has those like every other week. Other than that, sports PS2 games and a PS3 game. And then the Wii Play. Thought about getting that, but I already have a copy, so no point really. Other than that, there's nothing there. So we're going to go to the new Honey Hole Pawn Shop, see if there's anything there. So it'll probably be a clip of that after this. Peace. What's up, guys? Got a little bit of footage in there. Did end up picking up two NES games for $13. We'll show you guys in the pickups. Peace. What is up, guys? It's a Small Town Retro Gamer here. Let me move this a little bit. So we're here with the pickups. So first things first, you guys heard me talk about this on the subscriber contest video, how I got the Digimon Data Arena, or Data Squad. For the winner of the contest video is I did a trade with the guy who sells video games out of his mom and dad's shop. I was going to film in there, But his mom wasn't there, and I had the decency to ask him. It's not like a pawn shop or anything. I wanted to ask him. I felt compelled to, just to make it easier on me to not have to do it secretively. And he said, you know, if his mom was there, I'm sure she wouldn't mind, but I just don't want you doing it. Just, you know. So, besides that, he said, super cool guy. I brought in about $170 to $180 worth of stuff. And you know how most places, it's anywhere from like 50 to, the most I've ever seen a store give is 70% trade-in credit. But most stores, it's around that 50-60 range. And he gave me 110. So, I was happy with that. And I did get some games for myself from him. Starting off with Dracula, The Last Sanctuary. Get out of that glare. It is a two-disc game, which is crazy. That's nuts. Looks like it may be like an RPG or something like that. It says it has over 30 hours of gameplay. And he had that marked at 9, and it's about a $9 game. Because while I was there, he said he uses price charting primarily. If it seems wrong, he'll go on eBay. But he said he just likes price charting because it's a lot faster. And then he marks them usually a dollar or two below that, or, you know, a couple, a little bit below what price charting says. So Fade to Black. Let me get out of that glare that won't stop. Fade to Black. He had that marked at $3. The reason I picked this up is if anyone watches Cat Icarus, it's an older video. I just got into like Cat Icarus and the Peanut Butter Gamer and Brutal Moose. Brutal Moose. I just started watching those guys, and they're pretty funny if you haven't checked them out. And he reviewed that game. Yeah, he had it sold for $3. It's like a $5 to $8 game. But he reviewed it and said it wasn't great. It's like a spiritual successor though to Flashback, I guess. So, figured I'd check it out, especially for $3. Martian Gothic. Yeah, that marked at 6, if you can see that. Looks survival horror-like. So, love survival horror games. Those and RPGs, probably my favorite. And that's $8 to $10. And sports games. I love sports games, too. But Treg, Tactical Rescue Assault Group. Yeah, that marked at 6 as well. It's like a $7 to $9 game. And this one was kind of strange. Trap Gunner Countdown to Oblivion. It's an Atlas title. He actually had, there was another sticker on there for $5. And he was like, oh, that's not my sticker. I'll have to look it up real quick. And I said, okay, cool. And price chart has it at 38. So we marked it at 35. Complete in really good shape. But when I looked online, one had sold for as low as 12 and all the way up to 115 complete. So somewhere in there. So maybe the average was about 38 or something, price chart figured. But one of those games that's just all over the place as far as the range of prices goes. And then this game, Raw Danger. It looks like a budget title. $10 is what he had on that. Complete. And it is epic visuals capture the intensity of a natural disaster. So you're surviving natural disasters. I actually have seen some gameplay on this. People said they're actually pretty fun games. It's kind of like a new take on survival horror. You're surviving a natural disaster. So that was pretty cool. When I saw that, I had to pick it up. And that's like a $12 to $14 game. Power Player Paul actually picked up an Ape Escape game in one of his last videos. If you haven't checked him out, he's a cool YouTube channel. If I figure out how to put the links down below, I'll put a link to his channel. I picked up Ape Escape 3, had it marked at 20. It's complete. That's about what it goes for, $20 to $22. I've just wanted an Ape Escape game for a long time, so that's cool. And then another cool channel, Derek H, talked about this game, I do believe. It was a while ago now, but probably still find it. Custom Robo. He had that marked at 20. It does not have the manual, sadly. But you design robots and you fight in an arena, and it looks sweet. So I had to pick it up. I did put this one in. I've been playing through. I go back and I play through RPGs for some strange reason, even though they take so much time. And I started at Final Fantasy II for the SNES, or Final Fantasy for the NES. And I'm all the way up to now Final Fantasy X-2. So that's taken up almost all my extra gaming time that I have. Plus, student teaching sucked a lot of that out anyway. But I do plan, I have a huge backlog of games that I have to play. So, planning on playing a lot of these in the near future. And Custom Robo, around a $20 to $25 game without the manual, I'd say. Then we hit up thrift shops and some pawn shops. The first thrift shop we stopped at, which was nice to get back out there and find stuff at the first one. And this game is one I've never seen, Wings of War. Don't know if it's an Xbox and PC exclusive or anything like that. But I love dog fighting games, and it was only $3, so I picked it up. It's like a $7 to $9 game. Then they also had Spartan Total Warrior there for $3. One is complete as well. It's like a $5 to $7 game. I think I own this one on PS2, but I just picked it up because I didn't have it on Xbox. And then Gladius, which is an awesome game. If no one's played that one. I really like it, but I really like Roman and Greek mythology and like Colosseum, that sort of time era. I think is a time era that isn't explored in a lot of games, and I think it's awesome. You know, the God of War series, of course, kind of explores it, but I think it's an area that a lot more games could go after, but they just don't. And that's like a $7 to $9 game as well. So some pretty good titles there. Then we went to what I'm deeming the new Honey Hole Pawn Shop. The guys there are super cool. They do know me now, so this one they didn't really give me a deal on. $17. I was able to pick up a game that I've been looking for a while. The label is damaged, but Earthworm Jim. For anything, I've been looking for it. I played it as a kid. I didn't play a whole lot of it as a kid, but I just remember it being so fun that I've been looking for it since I started collecting. Have never found it, I don't think, even. Like, even at retail shops or anything. So, for $12, I picked that one up. Can you see that on there? Just trust me, it was $12. And it goes for like $15 to $17, so not a bad deal. This store was a store that had like Pokemon Black before the whole Pokemon Go craze marked at 55 loose. But it seems like they've gotten a lot better with their pricing and games, so that's awesome. So $12 for Earthworm Jim, couldn't beat that. Sorry guys, I had to pause that real quick. The other game that I picked up is Forgotten World for $5. Don't know much about this game. If you know anything, let me know. It's about a $9 to $12 game loose. Cover looks sweet, so maybe it's a good game. Don't know too much about it. Then this is another reason why price charting can sometimes be a little bit deceiving. Because I picked up this. It was sealed. You can see the seal there. I'm going to play it, so I just took it off. Disgaea 5, the collector's edition with the art book, soundtrack, and reversible cover. They didn't mark it $50, but my Hastings is going out of business. So I ended up paying $20 for it, which isn't a bad deal at all. And price charting, it said new, it was going for $130, which I knew it probably wasn't. When I looked online, it was closer to that $40 range. But I was super psyched to see this for $20. I couldn't pass it up. I love the Disgaea series. Like I said, huge RPG. RPG and probably survival horror are my favorite types of games. So couldn't pass that up for $20. And then, like I said, this went back to the Honey Hole Pawn Shop. And this game, when they were pricing crazy, I don't know who was pricing it first, was $25, I think, is what they had marked on it. I ended up paying $13 for these two. If you can see that, ended up paying $13 for these two games. The first game, Big Bird's Hide and Speak, for $3. Just an NES game I didn't have. And NES is probably one of the libraries that I'm trying to bulk up because I don't have a whole bunch of them. I just don't see them very often. Then a puzzle game, I'd call it uncommon. I don't know if it's rare. I had never seen it before, though. Kickle and Cubicle. Like I said, it was $25 when it was first there. Now they had it marked down to $12 and I paid $10 for it. And it came with its manual. So that's pretty cool. And a dust cover. Not a Nintendo one, but not bad at all for $10. And that's like a $15 to $18 game. So pretty happy with that. Like people tell you, or like people have said in videos before, if you keep going back and you keep just being nice, it's a big thing. Being nice, being friendly, you know, talking to guys, not being a dick. They'll usually do business with you. And then this one was an impromptu stop. It was at a pawn shop that I don't go to very often because all of their old games are $6. And they had 360 games and stuff marked on their own for like $15 and, as you can see, $10. So I got to talking to the guy and I said, how long have these been sitting there? Could you do any better for me? And I went with, well, it says all your other old games are $6. Could you do $6 for them? He went, no, I couldn't do $6 for them. You know, those aren't that old. They're da 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 da. And I was kind of like, all right, well, I'm not going to pay $10 for them. And he counted with $7 a piece. So I ended up paying $7 for these games. Hellboy, The Science of Evil, just because I have never seen this game.
And it came with a free movie ticket to Hellboy 2 that I'm going to redeem. Just kidding, because it didn't work past like August 4th, 2008. But it's cool to see. It's cool that it's in there. And these discs are in really good shape, too. That's like a $5 to $7 game, so paid $7, so on the higher end of what it goes for. And the game that I know it's horrible, I know it killed the Bomberman series, but Bomberman Act Zero. It's like a $5 to $7 game, too. But it's one of those games that I've always wanted to try because of how bad it is, supposedly, and I have never seen it. So when I saw it, I was like, oh, I want to get it. That's another tactic to use, is never be a jerk about trying to haggle at pawn shops, but kind of say, you know, how long have they been sitting there for? That's what I did. I said, how long have they been sitting there for? Could I get them for any cheaper? And he was kind of like, oh, I don't know. I said, well, your other games are $6. How about $6? And he went, no, you know, they're pretty new. They're not old games. We don't do $6 for them. I was like, okay, well, could you do anything for them? I said, I'm not paying $10 for him, and I did the kind of when you walk away thing a little bit, and he was like, well, how about we go $7? And I was like, yeah, that works. So that is it, guys. So the question of the day is going to be, what is, since I picked up Bomberman Act Zero, I have not played it yet, by the way, what is one game that people say is horrible, or people in general just don't like, there's a disdain for it in the community, that you actually like? Mine, and this may be kind of strange, is Duke Nukem Forever. It's not that I love Duke Nukem Forever, I just don't think it's that bad, and I think it gets a lot of hate. I get the hype that it had and all, you know, that it was in developmental hell for years. I don't think it's that bad of a game. It's not a great game by any means, but it's okay. Not bad. It's not a bad game. But what is one of the games that most people don't like that you at least don't hate? So let me know, guys. Like, comment, subscribe. Stay tuned for that 50 subscriber contest video. Winner. Peace.